Hello, friends. Welcome back to 7 Days to Die with your host, Rongo the Bold. Just look at this place. It looks really nice. I am pretty pleased with myself. I was going to restart and do that, but anyway. Okay, so we're going to take out these little bits. Working on the steam wagon, the paddle wheel. Now, my one concern is we're going to be putting a lot of weight on things. So I think I need to support the paddle in the center here. Because otherwise, I think we may have some issues. Okay, so that's the top part, paddle. Now here's where we're going to have a bit of a sticky wicket. Should have gone and grabbed some more wood between episodes. Actually, I think this is going to work. It's a lot of weight. It's a lot of weight. Okay. Now what I need to do that's where I was worried about things going odd on me. How can I? I don't know if there's any way. Let's set up a little test over here. So we've got one going that way. One going that way. Ah, we could. We could alternate the spokes of the wheel. Now we could do it. Yeah, we can do it. It just requires it doing it like that. But we have that beam in the middle. Ah, but we don't need the beam in the middle. We don't need the beam because we get the support from the things themselves. All right. So let's Make a bunch more plate. Oop, I'm running out of wood. And daylight. Yeah, I gotta take all this out too. Now, the minute I chop that, it's all gonna. Okay, so we've got. One going that way, and one going this way. Yeah, 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 it's working!
Yay!
Okay, and then on this side, we just need it to go. Down a bit. Ah. Fudge! Vanilla fudge.
No!
Well, I almost had it. Yes, I almost had it. Watch my O2. Yeah, I'll definitely restart the game before I come back to this, because it was looking really successful too, wasn't it? Wasn't it? So what went wrong? Hang on, I'm gonna go get some 2,200 hours. There's not enough time to get anywhere tonight. So let's just put that on. That's up, done. All right, this is still a viable option. I think it just needed a little bit more support. So I'll bring some scrap cable or some cable over as well for additional support for it. That'll probably make it all work. I could probably actually string it across the top to make it look, you know, like it's supposed to be there even, to help hold everything together. All right, we probably need to get back to the main house. Such a beautiful place. Actually, what I'll do, I'll spend the night. I'm gonna mow some more grass. I'm gonna put down some more. No dogs. Strange. Strange, but not unhappy. And I'll do a couple more rows of cotton prep. So I will see you guys back here in the morning, and we'll go back to work on the boot. Three. Oh, I'm saying three. I'm coming back, but I'm not coming back. I'm already back. So I spent the night. I went and got some couple trees, and then I spent the night punching grass. Punching so much grass, you would be amazed. So I got the lawn all done back at the house. I've mowed all of this. Which is pretty good, I must say. A good start for the day. I bump my athletics up from my punchins. So I'm gonna extend the field over to here. So I've got a bit more punching to do, as you can tell. We need to get rid of this stone pile. It's in the way. It does not belong. It is wrong for the plantation. It shall be decimated. Actually, it would be more than decimated. I don't want a tenth of it left. Choppity chop chop chop. Quiet night. I had three zombies the whole night. No dogs. So strange. But okay. I don't mind them not giving me dogs. There we go. Just about wrapped up. Beautiful. I need to start getting gathering these up to get seeds going, because it's going to take a lot of seeds to actually plant the field. And I'm also going to do a small, you know, house garden over actually like right behind the house back there, and that'll just be like the regular, you know, regular kind of garden. I think we're gonna go over as far as this. So this is as close as we get. So that's a pretty good sized field, I do think. So let's go ahead and turn. Oh, I've been making all the hays. Making hay while the sun shines. Get rid of those. Get rid of the chrysanthemums, and I need cottonseed. Okay, let's just plant these, get these going, because we're going to need to double this over many times. Oh, I like that new sprout. I hadn't seen the cotton sprout before. And it looks like it does not need to be planted on tilled soil. I'll still till it because it'll look better. But that's nice to know. And then hay. Hay. Fails. Alright, so we got 220 of these guys so far. Let's go ahead and stack them up. I want to stack a few around the side of the house. Or the barn. Just kind of, you know, a few just sitting. Then maybe a couple just out here. Yeah, just for decorative purposes. Rocking and go away. Come on. There we go. I have a nice big pile of hay out here. I wish there were animals. I really wish there were animals. All right, got some there. Let's put some on the other side as well. Yeah, it's good, and now thanks to JD Kempton for reminding me. This is called a hayloft. Yes, indeed. Hay. Doesn't need to be perfect. The whole idea is just to give it some, you know, some character and some. And then a few down here as well. And maybe one, maybe a couple here. Just to make it look a little lived in, you know? I like it! I like it a lot! Grow my cotton. Grow. I'm gonna grab these guys as well. Don't want to spend the whole time. I was supposed to be working on the boat. I was supposed to be working on the boat. Sorry about that. I got a quick thingy I had to deal with. Okay, so haze, dudes, things. All right. Let's make another 60 of those, because I'll probably break more of them. I will probably break more. So I've got some scrap cable that I forged up as well. I did make the recipe requires an anvil. Thought that was more appropriate. You gotta pound out those cables. Hey, I restarted and it's still making the noise. That's annoying. All right, so like we did here, I'm actually going to do it pretty much exactly like those. Okay, so that's that one. And it's going to be like that. Okay, so that's that piece. Now we need a piece on top. Let's go the grain this way. Okay, then we need the upside down piece. I want the grain to go Oh, it doesn't seem to change the orientation. Interesting, that doesn't seem to change that one. Nope! Okay, so we're going to build it with more security as we build. So I think that what that means is I'll use the scrap cables. All right, so give me some poles again. Poles, I need, give me 24 of them. You go away, you go away. Craft them. So require a lot more strength. Oops, wrong. I need it to be that one. Now, what if we also, right here, just for extra strength, extra strengthity. Put another beam there. That'll just add a bit more stability. Okay. I wonder if I get 2 episodes worth to get the paddle wheel on. I don't know. Alright. So we'll go with here. These are good enough. These will stand the test of time. Boom. Okay, we also know that we can do it there. So what we'll do is we'll put a scrap cable on here. Why won't you poke under? There's no frame right there, but why won't it... Why won't anything? All right. Oops. No. Do what I want, not what I do. Cable there, and there. Okay, that should give us enough structural stability to put the paddle in now. Plus, it gives us a platform to stand it all on. Okay, now the top piece. This. Now that's a thing. So what I'm thinking is, up on top here, we string another one. Does this have a down? It does have a down. Okay. that's gonna be annoying to work with, isn't it? Okay. So if I take this, well, it's sort of sitting on top of that. Now, these cables have amazing structural integrity. Okay, so that holds the top piece together. Okay, now we need it to be one of these guys. Come on. Oh, that was a cool, that was some cool parkour shit there. Okay, and now and so those will bind together to act as a support for the whole thing. Come on, fingers crossed, fingers crossed. Two more pieces. Yes! The paddle wheel is done! Ooh, yeah! All right, cool. So in the next episode, we will start working on the boat itself, like the rooms and stuff. We don't have a lot of space here, so it's going to be pretty minimal. I do want to go two stories worth, though. I think that'll look cool. So anyway, for now, it's been Wrong with the Bold. Hope you guys are enjoying this. Okay, let me know what you thought of my design. It's not perfect, but it looks okay. And we can actually grab some just for more aesthetics. Yeah. Oh, crap. Beautiful. Yeah, beautiful. All right, guys. I'll talk to you later. Bye. Awesome.